Here I'm asked to solve this rational inequality. First thing I like to do, if I can, is factor the numerator and the denominator. So the numerator here factors as x times x, 1 times 3 is 3, adds up to 2 if the 3 is positive, and the 1 is negative. Negative 1 times 3 is negative 3, so that factors up nicely. Let's look at the denominator here. Again, x times x. 15 factors as 3 times 5, and I'll get a positive 3 if the 5 is positive. I'm sorry, I'll get a positive 2 if the 5 is positive and 3 is negative. Negative 3 times positive 5 is negative 15. So this here is the equivalent to the original inequality. First step is to determine the critical values. Now the critical values are the zeros of the numerator and the zeros of the denominator. So by inspection we can see the zeros of the numerator are, what makes the zero here is x equals 1 and x equals negative 3. Now what makes the denominator zero here is a positive 3 and negative 5. Okay, so we know though that the zeros of the denominator are called restrictions. So I like to make a note here, because that's going to be important in a second. Let's go ahead and make a sign chart. Okay, here's a number line. Now let's put a closed dot. Notice we have the equal here, so let's put a closed dot at 1. These are my zeros of the numerator, and negative 3. Even though we have the equal there, I'm going to put an open dot at those restrictions. So I'm going to put an open dot at 3. And an open dot at negative 5. We never include restrictions in the solution set, but restrictions are critical values. Okay, so this breaks up the real number line here into 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 regions. We have to test each region to see if the result is positive or negative. So I'm going to choose a test value here of 5 and plug it in here to see if all the factors yield a positive or negative result. So 5 minus 1 is positive. 5 plus 3 is positive. Divided by 5 minus 3, which is positive. And then 5 plus 5 is positive. So all those factors, if I plug in 5, would be positive. So that's going to yield a positive result. So I'll put pluses there. Let's test the value here, 2. Substituting 2 in here, I'll have positive. 2 plus 3 is positive. 2 minus 3 right there is a negative factor. 2 plus 5 is positive. Okay, so I have 3 positives and a negative factor. That'll yield a negative result. Let's choose a test value in here, say 0. 0 minus 1 is negative. 0 plus 3 is positive. 0 minus 3 is negative. 0 plus 5 is positive. Okay, so here, two negatives, when I'm dividing like that, will yield a positive result. So I'll put pluses there. Continuing the test, test x equals negative 4. Negative 4 minus 1 is negative. Negative 4 plus 3 is negative. Negative 4 minus 3 is negative. And negative 4 plus 5 is positive. Three negatives makes a negative. We can't assume this always alternates. So you do want to test each and every value, each and every interval. Negative 10 minus 1 is negative. Negative 10 plus 3 is negative. Negative 10 minus 3 is negative. And negative 10 plus 5 is negative. Four negatives will yield a positive result. Okay, so this is our sign chart. Now we're going to use our sign chart to answer the question. The question is, when is this rational expression less than or equal to 0? Okay, when is it negative? So I'm looking at my sign chart and I'm going to shade in all the x values that yield a negative result. Then convert the shading into interval notation. Notice here we have an open dot at our restriction there, negative 5. So round parentheses, negative 5 to negative 3 inclusive, square parentheses, union, inclusive 1 to 3. Okay, so this is interval notation for the shaded region here. All these x values will work when I plug those in, I'll get a negative answer.